Hi, welcome back to my kitchen. Tonight we're going to make cranberry butter. And I can't think of anything better than to have a flavored butter to put on your rolls. And you don't want to make it too strong. So this is a half of a cup of course these cranberries are frozen. But I'm not going to put all of them in there. I'm only going to put a few to begin with. We'll see. I'm going to put the top on this food processor. And let's see if this will cut them up. We want to get them pretty fine. That doesn't hardly look like enough, does it? Can you see in there? No, I'm going to go ahead and put the rest. So this is a half a cup, frozen. All right. Oh, yeah. All right, the next thing going in is one stick of softened butter. And this is salted butter. I don't find it makes much difference whether you use salted or unsalted. Very few times, I'll put it that way, very few times, I never buy unsalted butter. All right, here we go. We're gonna mix that softened butter in with the cranberries. I'm going to have to get something to push those down. Let's see. I always have a bunch of spatulas. I've been cooking so much lately, I don't even know where they are, to tell you the truth. Alright, I'm going to push this down where it belongs. And don't try to do this with butter that's not softened. Part of the problem is that the cranberries were frozen. And I probably could have used a smaller bowl, processing bowl. So let's see if this works any better. Let's turn that off and we'll pulse. It looks good, but it's still not as fine as I want it to be. The color is wonderful, but it's just not not as well combined as I would like. Yeah, see what the coldness of the cranberries has made the butter harder. Alright, now you know how tart cranberries are. And you don't want to make this real sweet. You just want a slightly sweet flavor. Because nobody wants to bite into a biscuit that tastes like it's lemon, pure lemon. You know, that's got a real tart taste to it, a biscuit or a roll. You want a little bit of sweetness. And I'm going to put about two teaspoons full of confectionery sugar in there. And if that's not enough, we'll add some more. All Let's see what it tastes like now. Get it down from around here. Got a little bit on my spatula. I'm just going to test it with my finger here. Now, to me, that's perfect. It really is. It's perfect. It's not sweet, but it has a little sweet background to it. Excuse me. That would be good on a roll or a biscuit. And, you know, just imagine your ham or turkey. How good that's going to taste. Now, this next step is purely an option. I'm going to go for it this time, but I'm not sure that I will in the future. But we'll see how this works out. And that is the zest. And I'm not putting the whole orange. You put a little bit of orange zest in there. Remember to keep moving your orange around because you do not want anything beyond the orange outer parts. You don't want the white pith, as it's called. Just keep moving your orange. There, it dropped in. This is about the whole orange, but not quite, but I think that's enough. I don't want the orange to take over. I want it to be like a light background flavor, because you really want to taste the cranberries, right? All right, that got it right there. Put the top on, and we'll give it another go here. Just going to grab a paper plate, and I heated up these Parker House rolls. Get a knife. Oh, well, they look wonderful. So I'm gonna take this out. I say I am. I always have more trouble with this. There it goes. All right, just set it down here, and then I'm gonna get my Parker House. Let's see. There, you can see it. All right, you can't see me do both, but I'm gonna get a little bit of this butter. I'm going to spread it on this hot Parker House roll here. Oh my goodness, look, it's melting. Let's put the top on a minute. And in the meantime, I'm going to get a spatula and get all of this cranberry butter out of the food processor. and put it in a nice bowl and cover it with either aluminum foil or plastic wrap, and it'll be all ready for Christmas. And isn't that going to be beautiful? That beautiful red color. Let me zoom you in. You know how good I am at this, so let's see. Can you see that? Oh my goodness, that'll be so pretty on the table. Not to mention how good it's going to taste. All right, let's get back down here to our roll and see if it melted any better. Oh yes, it's all melted. Let's give it a taste. It is delicious. Not sweet, not tart. Just a perfect balance. So actually the formula for, oh, and I can taste that orange, it's delicious, is a half a cup of cranberries, fresh or frozen. Mine were frozen. To one stick of butter. And if you've got a decent size orange, this is pretty big. It'd be about 3/4 of the zest of an orange. Make sure your butter's softened. And I probably should have let my cranberries thaw a little bit. But I'm telling you, you can't beat this. You'll love it. You are going to love it on your table. Let's get down there. Look at that. Now I'm beginning to think this is a small roll because I surely do want to eat more. Now if you want more cranberry, you go ahead. You don't have to stick with that formula. But it was 2 teaspoons of confectionery sugar because it's going to dissolve much better in with the butter and cranberries than granulated sugar. You don't want it to be grainy. So 2 teaspoons of sugar, a half a cup of cranberries, and 1 stick of butter, and just, and the zest of about 3/4 of an orange. If it's a small orange, do the whole thing. Great. Soften it up in your get it all mixed together in your food processor with the metal blade. Put it in a beautiful dish, and your family and guests, they just won't know what to think about such an extra mile that you have gone to, because this is delicious, I'm telling you. It is so good. All right, guys. Thank you for coming back in today. I appreciate it very much. Please like and subscribe if you haven't. And in the meantime, you have a wonderful holiday season. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. You may not see me back again until after the New Year, but that's undecided. But if you don't, if I'm not back on, don't get worried. All right, take care, and I'll see you.